Hi guys, good morning and welcome back to BTV. On this video, I'll be updating you guys the incident that happened in Ibadan Polytechnic, also the incident that happened in Taraba State, and finally the response from the court swearing they did after they brought down schoolboy, some response of the Blackaxe confraternity. So first of all, we'll be talking about the Ibadan Polytechnic, the incident that transpired between Blackaxe and eiye confraternity. Though these two confraternity have issue for a while, but it has been on a low key for some time now. So there was a particular guy, is a Blackaxe member. So this guy, on his graduation day, where he was signing out, some group of eiye confraternity caught him. So they were forcing him to say his true name and to recite their Blackaxe orientation talk, to just to confirm in his own self, though they knew he was a member of a Blackaxe. So after some threatening and torturing this particular guy, I later have a picture that he was later brought down. Just imagine what cultism did to this young man. On the day you were signing out, that was a particular day they brought this particular down. That's why when I say no to cultism, say no to drugs, say no to crime. I know what I'm saying about. Just imagine, after the family have sponsored, definitely most guys who normally enter school, their family are the ones sponsoring them. After sponsoring this guy throughout secondary, primary, now he has finished his education, on the day of signing out, just to go and celebrate with the family, was a particular day they decide to bring this guy down. See the influence of cultism, the dangers of cultism in our society. The second we'll be talking about is the incident that happened in Taraba State between Blackaxe confraternity and the Vikings confraternity. The video concerning where the Blackaxe was brought down, he's swazzing. I don't even know the word to describe it. Some of you might have seen this video where this guy head was beheaded, as in it's injustice, as in to me, those people who did this particular stuff should be caught and brought to book. These people are not even meant to come out of jail for doing such thing to a fellow human being, because it's inhuman, for God's sake. No matter the confraternity clash you have with your own fellow rival, there are some things that should not even come to your mind to do to your fellow rival, because we are still brothers no matter what. We are one Nigerians. So what actually happened? They say the 7-7 that passed, the Blackaxe July 7 that just passed, so the Blackaxe was celebrating their 7-7 when they find a member of a Vikings. So they brought that guy down. Though I don't have the picture or the video of that particular guy, but according to the source I got, they say they brought that guy down. He was a member of a Vikings on their 7 July 7 celebration, and that Vikings happened to be the executioner godson. You see wahala, the sleep yanga go wake up. Imagine seeing an executioner godson, they go bring down, you know, see that one a big problem for one side. So after that incident happened, it did not go well with that executioner and the members of the Vikings in Taraba State, besides the school area. So The Vikings later find a Blackaxe member in a bush close to the school. So that was where they brought this particular Blackaxe down, and they behead him. They were showing the head in the video. Ah, God, only God will save Nigerian youth, and I pray for God to really save our youth, because we are just bringing ourselves for nothing. Just imagine, after bringing down so many, so you survive at your old age, you now sit down and start reasoning of what nuisance you have constituted all your life. How can you even tell your own children, this is the kind of life I live at my youthful age? Sometimes let's use our device. Let's think twice before we do anything. So finally, I will be discussing in this video, after the court swearing of the community that schoolboy came from, they bring Juju. They swear concerning who had a hand in bringing down that particular schoolboy, the maphite guy, and who is planning for more court activity in that community. So there was a response from the Blackaxe group concerning the court swearing. So I'll be also playing it for you guys on this video to see. So please, if you're just coming across my channel for the first time, please subscribe, like, share, and tell your friends about BTV. If you're already a family, thanks a lot. May God bless you. Please, if you have not belonged to any cult group, say no to cultism. The day you belong to any cult group is the day you dig a grave for yourself. Do not be deceived concerning the lifestyle they are living. What you not know is bigger than you. I must confess, say no to cultism. Say no to killing of each other. Say no to drug. Please, stay safe. See you guys on my next video.
I ask, man, I greet the ask generally. All these people they swear you are last with any grace. They don't know say the schoolboy and I'm on drowning you. Know? All the people where schoolboy don't feel key. No level, no see that you are no level. Maybe not is not no level. Schoolboy don't be mondra. You know how many men don't follow schoolboy and die. Because they swear you are last with key schoolboy. Schoolboy don't be injuries. You know no say injuries I be. Inju said that you drop us, your press drop you. Now that's where it be. You can't go the fuck with Aye. You know, say you go go down. No level. Aye Lala not do anything. We should be say people will kill her. I don't know how they take kill her or anything. Others want her before. No level. Nothing they solve. No level. That Aye Lala, my men will fist even locate her and go drop herself. They crazy. You don't know how many problems schoolboy don't give strong men before they drop her. I ask me, I greet the ass generally, man, bomb.